Everyone constantly faces challenges at home with our spouse, children, and other family members, at work with our peers and bosses. Sometimes life itself becomes a challenge because it throws up so many relationship-based and situational challenges. But the biggest challenge of them all is one's mind. Often it is possible to control everything else but one's mind. Being master of the mind is no less than mastery of the world. The Bhagavad Gita says, our mind is our best friend and our worst enemy. If we know how to manage our mind, we can manage our time, our relationships, our life, everything. This is where spirituality comes in. It is a path to a mentally decluttered, value-based life. Spirituality teaches us to control our thoughts, emotions, and desires. It is actually the science of managing one's mind. Once we start to have control over our actions, we may also find the law of attraction coming into play. Inexplicable events occur and we find things falling in place for us. They seem to be coincidence, but that's the law of attraction working for you. You attract what you think. When you think positive, you get positive results. Okay, so I'm assuming this is the end of the passage, and yes, it is. Right, so that was a quick read. And throughout the passage, the only thing that kept repeating, right? Remember I said, look for words that are repeating throughout the passage, right? You can, what will that help you with? Figuring out, okay, this is the theme of the passage. This is the overall theme or message, right? What is the one word that kept repeating throughout the passage? Mind, 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 right? That's the crux. So we figure that out. And then there's an introduction of spirituality being how it can help you, again, manage your mind. And then the last paragraph talks about, you know, law of attraction. So I want you to also pay attention to certain phrases that stand out, right? When you're reading, I want you to kind of quickly or mentally capture certain phrases. Inexplicable events occur. Coincidence, right? So when you're reading, I want you to kind of quickly look at keywords, highlighting words that are standing out in the passage. Why? Because there will be questions around those words. Now let's look at our questions and quickly answer them. So the first question that we have is, the central idea of the passages, the importance of managing external challenges, no. The need to understand the law of attraction that comes in the last paragraph. The value of spirituality in life, spirituality is a means by which you can control your mind. What's the essence of the passage? The importance of gaining control over one's mind. So just by paying attention to repeated words throughout the passage, I'm able to quickly answer this first question. First question answer is 4. Let's move on. It is possible to control everything else but one's mind. Means it is possible to control one's mind more than anything else. Confusing a little bit. It is possible to control everything else except one's mind. Everything else is achievable if one controls one's mind. Everything else is useless unless one controls one's mind. So obviously your clue is the hint antonym, but, right? It is possible to control everything else but one's mind. Means you don't have to answer what the passage is telling you. Understand the question. Everything else is achievable if one controls one's mind is one meaning. It is possible to control everything else but one's mind is another meaning. Please go back. That's why I circulated the hint word, which is but. This expression, what does this expression mean? It is saying it is easy for us to control everything else except our mind, boss. Option 2. Everybody is getting confused and picking option 3. Option 3 is saying you can achieve everything if you control your mind. Right? Let's not get confused. What is option 3 saying? You can achieve everything if you control your mind. Right? Everything else is achievable if one controls one mind. So what does that mean? But you can achieve everything if you control your mind. What is the main phrase? What is the question asking? it is possible to control everything else, but so the main question is saying you can control everything. And what is difficult to control is your mind. You can control everything, but not your mind. That's what it says. And which of the expression gives you that answer? Option 2. It is possible to control everything else except one's mind. Right? So, understand the phrase first, then you will be able to arrive at the answer. Don't get confused. For the second question, option 2 is the answer. The word decluttered in paragraph 3 means. So, clutter, I'm familiar with. Clutter means it can be a mess, garbage, whatever. You know? So, D means to remove. So, look at my options. To accumulate unnecessary things? Definitely not. To remove unnecessary things? Maybe. To clarify things? Definitely not. To board things? Definitely not. Obviously, it's option 2. Right? The word declutter means to remove unnecessary things. If you don't know what this word means, go back and look at the passage. What does the passage convey? Next. What seems to be coincidence? So, what is coincidence? Options. Events happening all around us. Events becoming inexplicable. Events falling short of our expectations. Events happening according to our wishes. So, what is a coincidence? Forget the passage, right? This is coming in the last paragraph. Remember, we looked at keywords, inexplicable things, coincidence, laws of attraction, everything came in the last paragraph. Right? You can go back and read that passage. I knew most of you will come back with option 4. But look at option 4. Option 4 says events happening according to our wishes. Then how can it be a coincidence, boss? If it happens according to your wish, then it is not coincidence. No? When you say, okay, let's say you and I said the same thing at the same time. Did you wish for that to happen? No. Then you say, hey, that's a coincidence, man. You and I thought of the same thing. You don't know, no, that it's going to happen. So how can it be option 4? Inexplicable means what? What is the meaning of inexplicable? Something that cannot be explained. I cannot explain it. So can you explain how that both of us said the same word at the same time? Cannot be explained. Inexplicable things. That which cannot be explained. So, let's say, you know, two of your college mates or people whom you're working with, your colleagues, right? You decide to, not you decide, you just happen to meet them at a restaurant, right? Same day, same time, both of you are there. So when you look at that person, you say, hey, what a coincidence, man. I never knew you will be coming here. Right? So that's a coincidence where it's not that something that you wished to happen. It just happened. You're just not able to explain how it happened, right? So what seems to be coincidence? Events becoming inexplicable. Events that you cannot explain. Now the third option, it's saying events falling short of our expectations, which means you have expected something. Right? You need to expect something. And then, if it doesn't meet your expectation, then it is falling short of it. Right? But that's not what coincidence means. Coincidence is where we are saying, I neither expected it, nor did I wish for it. That is what a coincidence is. So, the answer is option 2. Last one. How does the law of attraction work in life? This is an easy one. Look at our options. We start feeling positive. We make inexplicable things happen. We attract the things we desire, we find things falling apart. So, the law of attraction is mentioned there in the last paragraph again. Law of attraction, there is a clue word for you in the question itself. And there is the same clue word in the option. We attract the things we desire. That is what law of attraction is. You think positively, positive things will happen. You think negatively, negative things will happen. Right? That's what the paragraph says. That's it. So, those of you who did not get it the first time, go back, watch the video again, read the passage again, look at the questions again, and then figure out the answers.